We've flown over to Lanai for a special edition of Sam Choy's in the Kitchen. I'm John Veneri. This is world-renowned chef Sam Choy. We're at Sensei Farms.
And we're here to visit CEO Sonia Lo. And they got some great products for us to cook with.
Let's go check them out. After you, sir.
Hi.
There she is. Hi, Sonia. How are you? Good to see you.
Thanks for having us.
Wow. This is cool.
Beautiful.
Would you mind telling us a little about Sensei Farms, Sonia?
Sure. So Sensei Farms is the brainchild of Larry Ellison, the chairman and founder of Oracle, and Dr. David Agus, a prominent oncologist. They decided that between them, they were going to take on the small task of improving human wellness. And this is the food bit of it. So we are growing fresh, nutrient-dense produce for all of Hawaii. The nutrient density is, of course, also paired with being delicious, because it doesn't matter how nutritious it
that's
is,
right.
if it doesn't taste very good, nobody's going to eat it.
That's right.
We are now on every Hawaiian island and growing, as you can see.
Yeah, very nice. Beautiful.
How about, tell our viewers a little something about you.
So I'm the world's unlikely lady farmer. I came to this from the investment industry, and I'd invested in an indoor farming venture. And then Mr. Ellison found me and asked me to come and help build this. So very excited to be here in Hawaii.
Well, we're really happy that you're here. We're super excited to be here. Yeah. I do have one more question for you, though.
Sure.
Will you show us to the kitchen?
Absolutely. Let's go.
Yes. Yo, let's go.
The most important thing you have in this building, though, is this kitchen and that refridge.
I know, I love our fridge.
So would you mind digging through it?
Okay, will do.
Bring out whatever you need, whatever you want.
Okay, wow, here we go. We've got some Mizuna, some Zesty Blend.
Oh, man.
Some of our Rainbow Chard, arugula.
Mizuna is actually really good for you.
Yeah.
And some of our Lanai mix, our Genovese basil, and our purple basil.
Very nice.
There we go.
Purple basil.
And purple basil. It's super fragrant.
Is that like Thai basil?
Sid's eggs, that's correct, yeah.
Sid's eggs.
Sid's eggs, gotta love Sid. And then some of our beautiful purple eggplants.
Looks like a pretty healthy menu we're gonna have here today.
Yeah, I think so too. God,
some
beautiful.
Some of our
color,
orange
bell peppers.
Wow, this is
really nice.
So here's some beautiful salmon, wow.
Yeah, this salmon is like top of the line.
Fantastic.
This is a Velasco salmon from Diamond Head Seafood.
And then here is some of our Lanai venison.
Oh man,
wow.
And I wanna thank the gentleman that went out and harvested.
But we're not done. We still have box choy. Everything in here, whether it's a lot or not too much, he has to incorporate into this, whatever we're making. So would you mind doing the honors and lifting the box?
Okay, ooh.
Pull it out and show it to the cameras.
Okay, some
miso.
Miso sauce.
Okay.
And what's this one? Ooh, shoyu poke.
You can do something with that.
Oh, yeah, we can. We got a whole bunch of stuff we can do.
Fantastic. Bye-bye.
Okay, Uncle Sam, let's break it down. What's on the menu?
So we'll do two dishes. We'll do a miso salmon.
Okay.
And then we'll do a poke.
All right.
And
we're going to mix in some of the greens?
Yes.
Okay.
We're going to add some eggs to our boiling water, John.
Okay.
I want you to
That'll be another dish?
Yeah, that's going to be a nice little cute egg sandwich.
Okay.
Not what you think you would think, like making it like an egg salad and then put it in bread. The buns will be the eggs.
Ooh. Oh, wow.
Okay, all right. And then we got the venison. What are we doing with the venison?
We're going to sear the venison real quick. We're going to put some dry rub to it. And then we're going to sear it like rare. Let it rest. Then slice it thin. And I'm going to do like a kilogram, like a little ceviche. Add some lime, fresh lime to kind of cook it. And then add some cucumbers and some beautiful onions there, some green, and then some of the basil.
Do you hear that noise?
Yeah,
that's just my stomach.
Your stomach's growling.
All right, let's
and
get
then,
going.
And then I'm gonna add maybe some, we'll take a little bit and try some of that hot Hawaiian pepper.
Yeah, beautiful.
Okay, let's go, John. So the first two dishes we're gonna do the miso salmon, and then I'm gonna do poke.
Delicious.
Really, because you got so much nice greens in there. I want to incorporate the proteins with the greens.
Oh, Fabulous.
You know, and you got so much different varieties. That's just amazing. And of course, bok choy is important for us. So we need to incorporate our things that we have. So this is a nice miso sauce.
That is so good.
This is really good. You ever use this miso?
You know, I haven't. It's really a sauce made from white miso.
Yeah.
Yeah, delicious.
Very delicious. And I'm going to do a salad dressing with that when we're done. And I like to mix things because, you know, it's important.
Minced.
Yeah, minced real fine.
How long with that miso paste and the salmon, how long do you want to marinate it?
You would want to marinate about maybe 24 hours.
You would want to, ideally.
Yes, ideally. Okay. But because, you know, we're on a time frame here, we're going to just kind of like do it where it's going to be still tasty. But if you marinate 24 hours, it's very good.
Okay. Now, what did you season the venison with?
We just got some. We're going to add it. We're going to add more again because I got to do it more. John, I thought he was from India or somewhere out in Thailand or what, the way he likes hot food.
My tolerance has gone up, but not that much.
That's all I'm going to use. So mince that right now, because that's going to be for something else. But I want to get ahead on it. Okay, so now look at this miso, okay?
So, wow, beautiful.
Okay, what we got in here is some Velasco salmon that is from Diamond Seafood. That's just to die for. And then I've added some nice miso, white miso sauce. Now, let me finish the poke. Okay, John, after you're done with the onions.
You told me stop, so I'm done.
I'm going to have you put them right in the bowl right here.
Okay, all right.
And then do you want a smaller mince than this?
No, that's fine. Fine. Okay, then what I want you to do is revisit our lamb loin, venison loin. And then take that tamari. You see that tamari sauce? Yeah. Open that. I think you got to open the under bottom cap too.
Yeah.
And then we're going to cut this in half, and I want you to drizzle it right on the plate here.
No, it's open, actually.
It's already open? Okay, beautiful.
Now, why did you choose? We have like a whole bunch of onions over there. We have the nice sweet ones, the red ones. Why did you choose the red?
Because it kind of like adds a nice color contrast to what we're doing.
Okay, so it's all about the color.
Yeah, you know, everything's all about eye appeal.
So what exactly are you doing with this venison? That's the backstrap, right?
Yeah, we're kind of getting ahead, you know, because it's really fresh Lanai venison. I want to get some flavor into it now because when we're going to grill it, we're not cooking this well or medium. We're cooking this raw.
Okay.
I should say blue, right?
Yeah, blue. Delish.
Yeah, so we're going to just sear and then off, let it rest. Slice it thin, then we're going to add the goodies to it.
Almost like a sashimi then.
Yeah, almost like a sashimi. Then we can add the loin onto that too.
Right.
So I added, okay, so what we got in here, we got a nice seasoned salt of salt and pepper, some Lanai salt and pepper, and then you made some nice minced garlic, right? Olive oil.
Oh, great. Look at that.
And then we're adding some of Aloha Shoyu's tamari, which we called Asian gold. Yeah, don't be shy. Okay, that's good right there. And then get a paper towel and oil it and rub it on the grill so that the salmon don't stick.
How small do you want the cubes?
And cut that in half.
Yeah, that's so.
Yeah, and beautiful. Then. Yeah, very good. Uh-huh. And that goes right in there.
Okay. Okay.
Oil?
Yep. Right here, John.
Yep.
And then I just go right in here. That's it. And then when we get the
front half.
Yeah. Yes, and just go. Don't be shy.
Go ahead. You do that.
Not too much.
Make that perfect.
Okay, wait now, because I'm going to heat it up a little bit. Ooh. Is that okay?
Oh, good. Let's heat it up some more. Wonderful.
I just love these peppers, you know?
Peppers are delicious.
I mean, you know,
I'll eat it.
Okay, so we got that in there.
Fantastic.
Okay, now give it the little...
Did you want to do some soy?
Yeah, I'm going to add some soy too. Not too much, just a little bit.
Okay.
So we're done with our first two dishes.
Like this?
Perfect.
Yeah.
For many of us, this is how we think of beets, processed, pickled, and canned. or pre-cooked and packaged. But raw beets are so easy to prepare in a vitamin-rich veggie packed with lutein, magnesium, and potassium.
So you've just separated the leaves and stems from the bulb. These, of course, you can boil or grate raw into salads. What to do with this? Most people throw them away, but no, we don't throw anything away, remember? The leaves can be washed and eaten raw in salads. Really nice, nutty flavor. The stems take a little more care because there's a bitterness that needs to be cooked out. And for that, we need our favorite ingredient, garlic.
Chop a few cloves and the stems into bite-sized pieces. Saute the stems in olive oil until tender, then add the garlic. We're making an Italian dish called fusto di barba, viottola e aglio. Delicioso. Now back to Sam in the kitchen.
So John, the secret to grilling, you don't want to keep touching it. Once you get it on there, then you just want to shake it just to loosen it up, and you're good to go. You see, like now you just kind of tear it off a little bit.
You're just doing that right as the fire is coming up on your fingers, huh?
Yeah, we got gloves. We got these asbestos gloves, John. Beautiful. Go little by little. Yeah, you see what you just did? That's exactly it, John.
Okay.
You grabbed, you just swooshed it like that.
Yep.
That's perfect.
Okay.
Okay, on the fish now, Sonia, one trick that I've learned through my expert grillers in Alaska, on salmon, you turn it just once.
Yeah.
That's it.
Okay.
You don't keep going and going and going. Okay, John, now take it off and lay it up right in the middle and leave most of the leaves on the outside. Yeah, use that. That's a good one. Gentle.
Are we done with this?
That's done. We're gonna need it later for the beef, but.
You what?
We're gonna need it later for the beef, but let it burn off.
What all did you put in that?
Well, basically we did a straight kind of poke.
Okay.
And what we did was, the diced poke, the diced salmon, your purple onions that you diced,
right.
The green onions, and then the sauce was the sweet sour, sweet poke, soy poke, and then I added the Korean barbecue sauce there, and a little bit of miso, and that was it. And then some tamari, and we created this beautiful dish right here.
Very nice.
Very nice, look at that.
Wow. I'm gonna go put it next to the salmon that I grilled.
That's it, man.
Great.
What's next?
Okay, next we're gonna do the venison. That's gonna be real quick.
Can I go ahead?
Yeah, go ahead, John. Beautiful eggplant.
Yeah, they're really beautiful. Gosh, if you brush these with the miso, can you imagine?
Pardon?
If you brush these with the miso sauce.
Oh yeah, be deadly. Very good here.
Oh, you just want the...
Yeah, cut, yeah. What's the, don't roll on your hand.
No, I'm fine.
Sonia, what do you like most about Sensei Farms?
The greens are amazing. Our tomatoes, our baby tomatoes are absolutely delicious. I have to say, the setting is pretty spectacular.
Oh my gosh, I know. It's amazing.
Okay, John, flip.
Flip.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, wow, look at that.
Then we'll grill some vegetables. We'll have you brush some miso on the eggplant, which would be just to die for. And then, maybe use the back of a spoon.
Yep.
Yeah, there you go.
I'm curious to know what the future holds for Sensei Farms, because it seems like everything's just kind of going.
Yeah, so we're going to be expanding here on Lanai, and then bringing more fresh fruits and vegetables to Hawaii.
You're making the world a healthy place.
Making the world a healthy and delicious place.
There you go.
I'm gonna cut our meat because our meat's ready. I just want to thank the gentleman that went and got this for us. It was nice of him to go out and harvest this beautiful axis deer.
Not much?
Yep, right in there.
How much green onion would you like?
Maybe a couple more. Yeah, a couple more. Adding some lime, fresh squeezed lime, Meyer's lime.
Make sure I'm only giving you the tender bits here.
Yeah, very good.
You want some green onions?
Yeah, throw them in. Ooh, this is my favorite dish, this kilogram, growing up.
Oh, delicious. Because
I lived in the North Shore, and man, all the people in the camps out there.
Yeah, so that lime juice does its cooking action.
Yes.
Wow.
Like a ceviche.
And the salt is basically the tamari from before, plus a little bit more now.
Right. Tamari. And then I added a little bit of the Korean spicy sauce there.
Oh, yeah.
You've taken the venison and you're putting it
in the bowl here, and man, I tell you what, the wasabi leaves are just to die for. It looks so beautiful.
That did make it look pretty.
Wow.
So I just didn't want to just do it right here. A little piece there. Man, these tomatoes look really, really nice.
Delicious, wow. Beautiful.
The kilogram with the tomatoes galore.
With Lanai venison.
Lanai venison. Woo.
Vinaigrette.
We're
making vinaigrettes left and right. Dijon mustard.
Woo-hoo.
Red wine vinegar.
Red wine vinegar. Little salt. Little black pepper. And put a little tablespoon of our ginger. And then we're gonna add our famous Lanai honey.
Okay.
Turn that switch on.
Right on top of the basil,
high,
huh?
Go high, yeah. Give me a spoon of luna.
Huh?
Mix them with your...
Okay. Uncle Sam?
Yes.
Sonia?
Yes.
Salad dressing's done. Do you know what that means?
Time to eat?
Yes.
Time to grind!
Time to grind! I told you, time to grind!
Oh my goodness, look at this mound of food.
I know,
it's a lot of food, huh?
Uncle Sam, recap for all of us.
Well, we did the two salmons. We did the miso-yaki salmon.
Yep.
Took some of our sauces that we had, created it. And then we did a poke, which is a traditional island dish that's very popular. And then we just added some magic seasoning of what we had there. And those are the two things at first. And then we had marinated at the same time. Sonia and I had worked on the garlic and the seasoning for the beautiful Lanai venison.
Yep.
And then we just seared it to rare. And then we made a kelaguin with it. And then we did the egg sandwich.
Egg sandwich, yeah.
Egg sandwich. We had some mayonnaise and of course some cowboy gravy in the back there. And then we turned around and then we had this nice sweet peppers from Lanai, and then of course all the greens. And then of course we did a nice salad, and then we made a nice little simple Lanai honey vinaigrette with ginger.
Is this a lunch or dinner worthy of serving to your employees?
I think this is worthy of serving to our owners.
Oh yeah.
That's great.
Thank you for a great opportunity to be on the island. And
yeah,
you know, like I said, I've been here in 1968 and 69. I picked pineapples, probably in this area. We picked, in all those months of being here, we picked this whole island. I used to like way down by the ocean because it was really nice down there. And then up here, of course, it was cooler. And then we had the mid shift. So we came in at 3 in the afternoon to 11 at night.
Oh, well, you're welcome anytime. It's been wonderful having you here.
And as I said, this is my first trip here. And my grandmother grew up on this island, so it's kind of nice to be able to come on over here and and eat and and visit. It's great. I just want to say thank you so much again for showing us around, having us here, letting us in the kitchen. It's been fun.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for coming. It's been delightful.
But remember,
when Sam Choi's in the kitchen,
you can do the cooking.
Chef Sam Choy.
What do you call a deer with no eyes?
I don't know.
No idea. What do you call a deer with no eyes and no legs?
Oh no.
Still no idea. Is that okay, Sonia?